I never thought it was impossible. I think the day when we hit 100K, we were like, yo, now we need to hit up that 1 million. So right now, I don't think 10 million is too far.
Yes!
So thank you guys. So today, I just want to talk to you guys about this beautiful thing that we are all a part of right now, which is YouTube Shorts. My passion for making this stuff is really to engage with an audience. The number one thing that we love is making people happy. Like, I think there's nothing better than making people happy as a content creator. So our content, I feel it does a lot of that. People reach me out to me all the time, even when I'm at events like this or online, and people say, yo, you know what, I was feeling so down, but I watched your video and, you know, it turned my day around. Like, I'm not so depressed anymore. Those bad thoughts that I had are gone. So that's one of the big reasons why we do this thing. And to be honest, it's been rewarding for us. That's why we keep coming back. So now there's this new platform that came that's called YouTube Shorts. We jumped on it head on and we decided to go in full force. Because I remember, like I said, at the time we were making like very long form videos, and then we decided, you know what, for the next a few months, let's jump on two shorts and see what we can do. And we started doing it. Yeah. So it's like a minute. You only have a minute to tell your story. We've been, at the time, it was trending the thing of somebody trying to go somewhere, but when they get there, they themselves are already there doing the same thing that they wanted to go do. So that's how we essentially started this thing. That trend was big at the time, and we were like, you know what, let's just jump on this and see what happens. And this is what we created.
Usathi uyasabetha ke-CV uzithole sowusebenza.
Much what we did. I think we did probably about 7 videos in this stuff. At the time, you know, they didn't become big or anything. I think we got like maybe about 5 to 10,000 views. And then we kept doing them. We kept repeating, like Zion said, we kept repeating. We did the same thing. And then with each one that we dropped, we saw the numbers kept climbing, numbers kept climbing, numbers kept climbing. So that goes to show with the repetition also is a good thing to do. Which I also took from her. I guess subconsciously it was there, but I never really put it into words, and she really put it into words. So repetition is also a key to being successful on a platform that comes to like making like short videos. Yes, and then we'll talk about it.
Ha! Bon appetit!
Thank you. viral videos that we had. So the reason why I wanted to add this one is exactly that. We decided to do this thing out of fun, you know. We put it up to the internet, it went viral, people loved it, they shared it. Like a couple, I think probably a month later, I got an email, I thought even it's a hack or something, like one of the scammers. And then the guy saying, hey, we love your video, we want to make it a TV commercial, we want to take it to TV,
exactly what it is,
so let's go. But obviously, we couldn't do that because of the aspect ratio of this video. It was like a long video. So we literally went on and reshot the video, and then we repurposed it for TV. And it did pay on TV. It still pays on TV. So that's the thing, guys. Whatever you're doing online, don't take it as, oh, it's just a small thing. I just do it, whatever. There's always going to be a moment where you do something, and people are gonna love it so much that they wanna take it further. So always put the 100% in everything that you do. So this one, it was really cool. The fact that we went on to work with this brand just like that. Right now we're partnering with them, we're doing stuff. Like my wife was here, she was the star of the show, obviously.
Hi,
Bakone.
Mara le khona bo kukulu bo ra kholo la khale le be ne ba le kamo le kamo o ka ra fedi le ka re ba reka ke re a setse gore a ke ba bona le na le le re tsa o nno a tshe na mine ka ba le na le tsa ya se she gore ba ka no re ba ditse ba apea ba
nna tena
ba khota ka go tswere bi tsare ke motlong ba tshela yona ka mohare
ba botsa tlhaga
ba tshela yona ka mohare wa ga mona ba ga mona ka re mogolo re ba squeeze ka mohare moya tsara mama tshidi
mmm
bona le fast time ba bona wa bona ke mmm na ufa pana ke se motswana fa le nna ena ka no tsiba ka le ka le fikole le mmm wa le bala wa tshwara litho u tlo o ba se fofu
mmm
ya fofatsa ba bana metsana bona la ka bo and error bona le mosetsa ka ke wena go re u je na mo tsontsi ke busharedi bona go re ba je na mo ba tsontsi ba ena ene ba tshoreni di ma ja di bushara ba tshimisa di tshinyo se be le tshinyo sa bo kokolo ba go bo o di bona o di a tere o tlhalosa gore no o ba re ye ke ya basadi ye ke ya bane e ke thetho ke ya kapele a ko mosadi ka se ya peka fa re ka so di kupe tse ka felele ka morao wa ke re nyetswe o na le mogaladi a ke re
ke o tshwaetsa ka bona
kapile le ka murao batho ba bangwe ba sike ba bona ene ka tlhanga ba bangwe ba sike ba bona ba khupetsa
Kill, what? So adile itriso ke a queen ka ntlo ka ofela.
Okay.
Let's go look at our thing.
lost. Have we got our lines crossed? We're wasting time on stuff that doesn't really matter, while wishing for something better. I try to fix things that weren't broken, misunderstandings and words unspoken. We fall apart and I won't dare to say, do you feel the same way? Maybe you don't want to know.
Hello.
Very sweet. It's nice, ne?
Very sweet.
And the amazing thing is that to make cheese, you use the milk from the evening, which has been skimmed, and the morning's milk. And then you add two things. You add bacteria and enzymes. The bacteria, and when you make cheese, are called the culture. And the enzymes are the rennet. In nature, you find rennet in the stomachs of young mammals. So to be able to digest the mother's milk, they have rennet in their skin, and the rennet binds the proteins called casein. Have a look at this, done by the enzymes. The enzymes, very, very interesting aspect to cheese making.
Sour,
isn't it?
Bitter.
Sweet. Nice.
Oh, sweet.
It's just like milk, it hasn't changed. The enzymes bind the proteins together, but don't change it.
What is this thing called?
We call it a harp because it's like the music instrument. But its job is to cut the curds into similar sized pieces so that they all go through the process the same. So today we're making our medium cheese, the mochi, and we're making it with garlic. So you see an interesting aspect of cheese making. Cheese stays behind. But we use it to turn the curds. a very strong, very firm taste.
So, all the cheese starts like this,
yeah? Yeah. Feta, camembert. I was saying that with the same culture and rennet, if you don't stir this too much and you put it into the forms, more liquid stays in the curd, and that will make camembert. Mm-hmm. In fact, for the camembert, they put the mold in with the liquid. There you go.
Oh.
You can see that my cup runneth over. When I look at this, I feel very, very rich.
Uh-huh.
Because if I use this to feed the soil, then the soil becomes rich and it produces well. Then we can do well on the farm. Now, good cheese is now. You see the curds are coming up and the whey staying behind. If our calves have diarrhea or anyone on the farm has a stomach problem, the first thing we give before any medicine is whey. Whey is also very good. Francisco wraps that around the blade, and then the process involves biting the cloth, and then he follows the contour of the pot with the blade and fishes out the leftover curds. Now all the curds are together, jampojou garlic, squeezed into there, and it needs to be mixed very well so that it's all. So these curds are going to work fast now.
Yes,
I was just saying that our oldest daughter was born when we went to Switzerland and we learned this. I was washing nappy. Okay, you see the forms that are going to be used. What do they look like?
Feta,
yeah.
But the forms are yogurt cups when we melt it cold. So take here.
How long will you keep
it? We will keep it. It makes this much cheese. Mm-hmm. Because the rest is whey.
Mm-hmm.
We take it, it stayed in the bucket, mm-hmm. was flowing out there.
Mm-hmm.
And so you can understand why cheese is the price that it is.
Mm-hmm.
It's about half a container now, hey?
Mm.
And now after this, Francisco is going to use a container without mold, and he'll put warm water in it to keep the cheese warm for longer so that it can still get a perfect shape.
Mm.
type of cheese, and it should have a very stinky surface culture that gives it the same color. And our staff couldn't cope with that stinky culture. So we just put the coloring on to make it look the same. Let me give you all a taste of cheese, and then you can look at the cheese roof. The what you need, the cultures and all that. And then we do the same. Just check this another
thank you.
Okay. Here are tastes of the Emmentaler. I think I might have some for the little boy. Yeah. On the cheese, and it's keeping the cheese warm so it can still change shape.
No, I don't think you can put it in the fridge.
This cheese all time. Or 3 days, depending on the weight. Because there's more absorbing that must happen. And we don't put.
It looks old.
So like if you see a cheese like that, take the weight, multiply by 10 or 14, and you have the amount of milk that
we can do. Oh man, and price.
Sure. Yeah.
Welcome to In Limpopo.
They give you the blue cheese.
Mm.
Never expecting phone.